Okay, for this video, we want to talk about what's going to happen when you book an appointment in our office. So this is going to be a little bit of a different experience for you rather than just going to a practitioner and then just trying to kind of get in and out within 5 minutes, kind of figure out where you are, renew your script, or get you on a different medication and on the way. The first things first is we're going to sit down and we're going to do a pretty involved health history. We're going to ask you an awful lot of questions about what's going on with your health, where it's been in the past, where it is now, how things have transitioned, and most importantly, what's the plan moving forward with maybe the practitioners you're already seeing? Because if they don't have a plan, it's hard to get where you want to go. So there's going to be a lot of questions. Some of it will be around your diet. And again, we want you to be honest because nobody's perfect and nobody expects you to be perfect, but we want to know what we're dealing with as far as dietarily wise, if that's going to be something that's aiding your healing or impeding it, you know, where it's going to become a problem. Same thing with exercise, not just physical exercise, but also, what are you doing with your body on a day-to-day basis? You know, do you have a physical job? Are you doing manual labor? Are you sitting around at a desk all day? Is it more sedentary? There's no right or wrong within any of that, but it all paints the picture of what's going on with your unique health profile. Also, what medications you're on. You know, when we look at lab work, part of what we want to look at is how is that medication working? What else might it be affecting? And how is it, you know, changing your body? And is it getting you ultimately what you want, where it might be treating your symptoms, but is it getting to the root cause of what's causing that problem in order to eventually make this a thing where you don't need it anymore? Potentially, maybe you can work with your doctor getting off of it or something along those lines. But that brings us to ultimately labs. If you have lab work, especially anything recent, bring it. Even if it's older, why? Because what we want to look at the trends. We don't want to just see where you are in a snapshot of right now, because if this is the line where you don't want to go across, and each time they're doing labs over the years, you're going this way, well, eventually it's just going to be a matter of time when you're here. So once you're here, you're already in trouble, and now we're scrambling versus if we're seeing this happening, can we get to that before you cross that line and have this become a much bigger problem? But also understand the thing about lab work. Lab work has huge values that they will let. The TSH is one of those things where they've been for years recommending that they change the TSH lab values to be a much more tighter range, because they'll give you, you know, typically from like 0.4 all the way up to 4.5, depending on the lab, sometimes higher. For TSH, that's a huge range. People on the upper end or the lower end of that range, they are going to be functionally in range, but functionally sick. We know what the optimum ranges are. This is where you will be the best. This is what the optimal range is. This is where you're healthy, not just not really sick. Because you'll still have symptoms at those ranges, but it'll look fine on paperwork, and the doctor won't say anything to you about it one way versus the other. There's a difference between those big ranges and the middle range of that, which is functionally where you want to be, where your body is working the best. You also not only have to look at the thyroid markers, but you also have to look at other things like liver markers, kidney markers, digestive markers. Digestion plays such a huge role, especially in autoimmune diseases. And not to mention the actual immune system itself, because you want to look for discrepancies of what those numbers are doing. Is there a balance to your immune system, or is it out of balance, which would indicate that there's some sort of autoimmunity pattern going on? Again, this is about gathering a lot of information of what you already have, what you've already been through. Now, if you have an active diagnosis, a lot of that stuff gets a little bit simpler, because then you start having the conversations of what do you do, why is this happening, and how do you fix it type of thing. But sometimes if we have to find what that is, if there's anything they don't have right, if they don't have all those 10 steps for the thyroid, that gets ordered and run out so that we can see. That way, once you have all of the information, the path to walk becomes really obvious, and then you have all the tools and the technology and the ability and understanding to actually put that together to get a person well. So when this is something you're coming in for the first time, this is going to be a really different experience, but that different experience is what allows us to get some of the results that we've been able to get with people who are dealing with thyroid and other problems, especially autoimmunity issues. So we look forward to hearing from you soon. Hope these videos have been helpful. Give us a call. We'd love to help you out.